So now that we have the dream solution and we all decided it's best, we move to prototyping, right?
That's right. Prototyping is a wonderful way to test your ideas. In fact, we want to make prototypes that are real enough to feel so that we can test them with users. And that's all that's required. Prototyping can take many forms. The simplest is to do a paper prototype where you can quickly gather feedback. One level up from that is to work on digital designs that are mid-fidelity or high-fidelity. The higher the fidelity, the easier it is to test and get feedback from users because they're looking at something that's a little bit more polished. A next level of prototyping is actually creating physical prototypes. When you work on something like Project Glass at Google X or Project Loon, it's not about software always, it's about what does the physical device look like. So that's when it's useful to have materials that help you create a quick shape of a general idea. Other prototypes that we have made include video. In fact, if you're trying to explain a product to someone, creating a video is super, super useful.
Yeah, Dropbox did that.
That's right.
Yeah.
The little how-to videos that a lot of companies use to describe their services are really useful in the design phase. If you make it straight on, even if it's shot with a little mobile phone and the users are the friends that you're working with, that can be sufficient to explain the idea to a user or to an investor and to test it. If you want the high quality prototype, you need to spend longer developing it.
So I can actually code it.
That's right. I think coding a prototype is a great idea. So some people are able to really sprint and within two days start to already code the prototype and then you can have an interactive demo. Or some people take maybe 4 or 5 days depending on how complex the solution is. So the duration of the prototyping phase is usually what determines the duration of the sprint. This is the key aspect in which actually the work is getting made. If you're someone who loves to code, who loves to design, this is kind of like the phase that you really get to shine. And if you're looking for a low fidelity prototype, a short sprint, a few hours might be sufficient. If you want something that's high fidelity, or requires a demo or a video, you're better advised to have a whole week of the team's time so you can make something beautiful.
How do I know which to choose? If I choose a high fidelity or a low fidelity, what is the best?
Okay, so if you're working on a new product, it's probably best to shoot for medium fidelity. That means that you're not looking at paper prototypes necessarily. You might have some early wireframes and that you're starting to put some color on them, or that you also use Keynote or a quick prototyping tool that your engineers know how to use in order to bring some life to the ideas. We believe in teams choosing their own prototyping tools. There's a lot that are available on the market, and the right ones are the ones that your team loves to use. If you're wondering where to start, Sketch is a really great example. So is the Adobe Suite, although it does take a little bit of time to learn. And then Keynote and Google Slides are also really useful in prototyping quickly.